I said think like tanam when he sang swaram, and you'll know why I said think like tanam when we sing tanam. That's very important for our music, that punch that is required. Da ga 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 So when you teach tanam, the whole difficulty in tanam is how do you create, again, it's a question of form, but one form leads to another form, leads to another form, leads to, and you're always going up and down, up and down, up and down, within a certain range. This is very difficult to do primarily because the laya is flexible. It's the form that is important. So I don't have to be on a chatushra beat at all. So the forms of fives, forms of threes, forms of two. And for the artist to get to a point where they recognize that they actually bumped into a new form to move there, that's the difficult part. You can't teach that. So you just have to indicate that you bumped into something. Use it, and then that will lead to something. So it's almost, tanam moves in a cyclical forward movement almost, in a way. So now, I've now sung only this range. I'll ask one of them to sing. Form padi padi mati neva. You can pick off each other.
Anatum num danum num. Num da num da da ga ga num da da ya 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 num num da da ya num da ga num num da num num da num da da ga num da num da num num da num da ga ga num da num da num num da num da ga ga num da num da num num da num da ga ga num da num da da ya ya 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 num da da num da da ya ga num da num num da da ya ga num 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 da ya ya num da ya 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 num da ga ya num da ya ya
கேடி வச்சு பாடு
அனும் தனும் தும் ததகனும் 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 ததகதகனும் ததகனும் ததகனும் ததகதகனும் ததகதகனும் ததகனும் 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 தும் ததகதகதகனும் தத்தகனும் ததகனும் ததகனும் நும் ததகனும் தனும் நும் ததகனும் நும் நும் ததகனும் Tayanum 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 tayanum
tayanum tayanum tayanum ஐகனும் தன பிரமேஸ் அதி எடுத்துரு ஐகனும் ததகனும் 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 ததனும் தும் தும் ததனும் தும் தும் ததனும் If you change the primary premise, you won't get stuck. You're stuck there. Change that. Aigaganam tum tadadum tum te aigaganam tum tadaganam 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 tadaganam
tadaganam tadaganam tadaganam tum tadaganam num num danum tadaganum tum danum num danum tadaganum tum tadaganum tum tadaganum tum tadaganum tum tadaganum tum tadaganum 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 nom 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 ta ga ya ta ya 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 nom ta
bade
ta ga 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 ta ga 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 nom ta da
nadi padre erda padu
ha nom 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 ta ga ga ta nom 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 அவசரம் உடம்பாடு
gaganum num dadagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagagag nom nom da da ga nom nom da da ga ga nom 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 da a ga 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 nom da a ga 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 nom da da ga ga nom da nom da
paral padu sing sing chuk par
nom 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 da ga ga da nom nom da ga ga da nom nom da ga ga 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 nom 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 da ga da ga 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 nom nom ta ha nom nom da da nom nom ta da ro ga ga nom da ga ga nom nom da 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 ga ga nom 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 ta da ga nom nom ta da ga 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 nom nom ta da ga 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 nom nom ta ga 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 nom nom ta da ga 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 nom nom ta ga 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 nom nom ta da 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 ga nom nom ta da ga nom nom ta ga ga nom ta da ga ga nom ta da ga ga nom ta ga ga nom ta da ga ga nom ta 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 ta da ga ga nom tom da 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 ga ga nom tom ta da ga ga nom tom ta da da ga ga nom tom ta da ga nom ta da ga nom ta da ga nom ta ga nom ta nom 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 ta ga ta ga tom ta ta
mere dattu suma paadu varum
இதெல்லாம்
பாடிட்டு கடைசியில பொறிச்ச சாலந்து அடிச்சு முடிக்கணும். அப்படி பாடுவோம். சோ யூ கீப் அப்ரோச்சிங் நீ ஃப்ரம் ஹியர் அண்ட் தென் யூ ஃபிளிப் இட் ஆன் இட்ஸ் ஹெட் அண்ட் தென் ஷோசா. சோ வெல் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இன் கிளாஸ். Of course, there are hits and misses for everybody, but that's what a classroom is all about. It's as challenging for me as it is for them, because I'm also pushing my own ideas, because when I say that I have to limit their ideas, I have to also limit my ideas. So I think I gain so much from singing with them. I don't know how much they gain, but I gain a lot, because it allows after a point, there's no teacher-student happening here. I mean, it's just three people jamming after a point. That's how it should be. After a point, it should be three people actually jamming. And because there are some great ideas ideas I picked from them today. I did not get those ideas. It was little things that they sang. So I think that's when the classroom becomes really alive, because it becomes very enriching for everybody. Because your antennas are completely open. You're completely like cued in to even find that little thing that you can pick. And then something happens. Something also doesn't happen. So it also allows, all my students have cried in class. This is one standard thing. They've all, at some point of time, now they are too adult to accept it. But this is before they became adults. Primarily because you keep pushing. I keep pushing myself. I keep pushing them. Till the point where it just breaks and says it's... And I think that's one of the most important parts of the learning, when that point of breaking happens. You know, when you're just so exhausted trying something and you actually collapse emotionally in exhaustion. Actually, when that happens, I'm sure the student will wake up. I'm very happy when it happens, actually. Cruel it sounds, I'm very happy, because I know then that a transition has happened in terms of what you do to yourself. Afterwards, of course, it's up to the student. So this is how we sing. Even in Alapana also, we could be the smallest things. Like I discussed last time, how the phrase is between. You can find a phrase between phrases, within the phrase. I'm not going into all that. It's on YouTube. But the same thing we do in the classroom. Identically the same thing. We just pick one phrase, one region, and okay, let's sing. Now suppose you're going to take a ragam, which is unusual. Just for, one of those ragams that are limited in scope, where usually you think you don't find much to do with, the raga itself. So what do we do in the raga dikla? This raga is called Jayantasena. The scale of the raga is Sagamapadasanidabamagasa. This famous Tyagaraja Kirtana. Vinata Sutava Hanashri Ramana Vinata Sutava Hanashri Ramana Manasa Rakase Vinchadarama Vinata. So this raga usually not sung too much. You sing swaram in it, but ragam is usually rare. But it's also possible to try and sing this raga. So one of the first things you must do when you sing a raga like this according to me, is try and tap into something that is unusual, straight. Is an unusual phrase straight for the raga. What it does immediately, it just changes the framework. Otherwise, what will happen, I'll be stuck with a kirtanam. There's only one kirtanam in it. Na 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 is standard. Open it. This is not found in the composition. No, suddenly Jayantasena has it. Different color coming to it. This is what you try to do in a classroom. Because if I ask them to sing Jayantasena, I know what they will do. Stand up, chuma padan. Which is not wrong. I mean, which is not wrong. I'm not saying it's wrong. It is thing. But if you want some different color to suddenly emerge, even in a Jayantasena, which seems like a little thing, it's not a little thing, then you have to kind of reframe the approach itself for the student. So the baseline I will throw in is something like this, and I'll say, sing. Now the student is totally off, because that's not a phrase the student is used to start thinking of Jayantasena with. But that also allows possibilities. Chuma padan. Yara ortu.
Tadarana.
Sabash. Okay, I'll tell you what happened now, okay? So what happened now, he started with the phrase, but then he went back to, singing framework, which is okay. So the question is, how do you push now? Sometimes it's also good to ask him, just repeat what you're singing. They don't need to sing something. So sometimes what happens, that also helps. Because when you take a ragam like this, it's normal. When I sang Jayanta Sena for many years, I would only sing what Rithvik just now sang, which is fine. But then this also is possible. So then sometimes you just sing phrase and say, just repeat after me. Just sing the phrase. Then the phrase becomes a earworm. See, only when these things become earworms, do ideas come. They have to just be there in their head permanently. When they're going home in the night, when they sleep, that one phrase. I'm sure he won't forget that phrase. I know that. Now that's enough. Because that's given a new window to how he can look at Jayanta Sena. Nobody thought that Devata can be used that way. Vinata Sutava Hanashri Ramana Manasa Rakase Vinchadara Ninosa Raguzu. No, Tadaralala just gives you a different take. So this is also the role of the guru, to try and give a different take to a possible raga. The presumption is that first the student has reached a point where they can understand that it's a different take. This is the baseline presumption of my statement. If the person is still at a stage where you're going to be teaching them the basic framework of the ragam, then all these things are out of question. You do not do this because they'll do all the wrong things. Because the context of how this should be presented will be lost in the students. So after that, then you have to push these little pedals here and there and say, okay, suppose you look at it from this angle, how does it sound? Or even if you take even a ragam, which is like a, even Chaitasena is more of a scale, but even if you take a full scale, for example...
No, I have a question with this. You said this is the only song in this ragam, so which means our understanding of the ragam comes from this one song which is there.
Good question.
So when you say you got a different take from that, so where does that come from? How do you reinterpret a note that is not there?
Very good question.
So in a song which we use as a
framework. So one argument can be that you should not do it. No, there could be that argument. I'm placing that argument also there. Because there could be an argument. Jayanta Sena's only source. The only source is Vinata Sutavahana. This doesn't exist there. So now, where does this come from is a very difficult question which I don't know how to answer. But I think it comes from, once you internalize this raga or this kirtanam, and you start singing the kirtanam, then you kind of hear the color of the ragam. Color of every swara. Okay. Once you start in context of that aesthetic, Once that is imbibed, then naturally you know how you can use something after a point. I know I can use pada. I can do. I won't do so much with the nishadam. Now, these basic things are given by the composition to me. Now, Tyagaraja may not have used da, da, ra, no, he may not have used that, but he's already taught me that the da is there. It has a very distinct possibility there. But the nishadam is not. I just keep flipping it. Da, da, ra, na, 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 ra, na, ra, ra, na, na. That nishadam does not have much of a role. So I learned the color of every swaram in that composition. Now, can you push that too? That's a far more complex question.
But can you, in, for example, if you want to add the nishadam, like something like...
Now, but if you stand on knee...
Not stand, I mean... You can
that's
use
a little
that
problem. You can use it, but you're still going to keep dropping it. No, you want to use the knee... Na na, you'll still use it as a cut note. Ta da ra na, you never do that in the ragam. So there are these things that you get. So even if you use the knee, which you can, all depends on what you've sung before and after it. If you've built that raga enough in imagery into yourself and everybody listening, then the knee will also sound like the ragam. That's the greatness of great musicians. They've immersed so much into the ragam. And immersed you so much in the ragam that any swara, which may be the weakest swara, will still sound like the strongest swara in the ragam at that point. That is the brilliance of the musician. So, but you must get to that point. You can't hop, skip, and jump there. So, to get to that point, to be able to sing that, I should have built Jayanta Sena so much that when I sing, you'll say, aha. You know it's just something coming out of the blue. But at that point, it doesn't matter if knee is weak. Now, that is artistry at its most beautiful. But even if you don't go to that point, go to the point of at least using what you have from the composition, you still have a lot of indicators. To use that to create it's not a new phrase or thing, it's just a new perspective. Instead of looking at it like this, I'm saying looking at it this way. That's all we are saying. Otherwise, then you won't go anywhere with it. That's the problem. This is true of as much of the large, bigger ragas as it which is a smaller raga. But in a bigger raga, because you have so many compositions in it that give you so many different ideas already, your bandwidth of access in terms of what you have, in terms of data, in terms of understanding is so much more. In these ragams, it's so much less, which also makes them as exciting because there's so much less for you to take from. You know? And also, this also teaches you how you don't have to be stuck with scale. That's a very important aspect. Some of these ragas have come from scale. But I've always wondered about how do I even take a scale and get it out of its own trap. So that is also something that this can teach you. The moment you shift, you can sometimes escape the trap. Now, for example, pada nida, I don't think it's found in the composition. Correct? Because it's pada pada sa nida pa. Composition lirka. I don't think so. Pada sa nida pa is there. Now, that is something that usually people will not sing, but I would sing. Because that allows me an escape route. Now it's a question of how I sing it. I won't sing. I will sing. So these are little things that you can pick and not get stuck. There's no point getting stuck. Now, D.K. Jayaraman sang it, for example, quite spectacularly. That was his hallmark. This composition is pretty much known by, I think this is a Naina Pillai, he learnt it from the Naina Pillai tradition. Both Pattama used to sing it, Brinda Mukta used to sing it. There's small version variation, but Brindama used to sing it beautifully. And D.K. Jay, Swaramata Bedamane, Swaram there is like legendary. I know it by heart. The first two Swarams I know by heart. Because I've heard that recording so many times in my life. Ma, ma ga sa ga ma ta be fa swaram. second swaram in the recording that we've heard 100 times. So we have source of these, other than learning it from your guru also. Sometimes, see, another thing is now compositions are not only learned from gurus, they're also learned from recordings. That's a reality. There's no point cribbing about this and complaining about it. That's a reality of today. The compositions are learned. But that creates its own complexities, right? When they learn from a tape, sometimes there are issues with it. But we have to deal with those issues, fortunately or unfortunately. It also, but at the same time, there's benefits from it because they get exposed to different interpretations because these recordings are also available. So it's a double-edged sword. Any questions at this point, or we can just go on? Yes. Sadashiv Rao, is it? Okay.
Yeah, namaskar. So you said that these are like the semi-rakti ragas which have a basic...
I didn't use those words.
Okay.
Those are your words. I'm very careful about what words I use. This rakti raga and all is very complicated terminology.
So this has a basic... that is the aronam aronam. How far do you push the aronam aronam?
So I would introduce, for example, a swara that does not exist.
Of course.
Okay. That's so, kind of a given.
No, just like the padanida that you did.
So, yeah, those are... So, where do I learn that? Let's look at that. So, that's the whole beauty. Now, I learned to do these pushes on these scales from the organic ragas that I know. Now, you take, for example, Kamboji. Sarigama padasa. You sing padanida in Kamboji?
Yeah.
So, why can't you sing padanida in Jayantasena?
Okay, but again...
You understand the logic?
Yes, but...
So, what you learn from is not the scale ragams. So you go back to the organic ragas that came from just phraseologies. See what are those things that we have moved in them. And try to see if you can use the same ideas into the scale ragas. Because by the way, the gamakas in the scale ragas, where do you learn from? How do you know if you sing? Where do you learn it from? Because sadhar ragandhar and old ragas are all sung like that.
Yeah.
Truth. So you learned the gamakas in Latangi or in Simendra Madhyamam from listening to what the older ragams. We did it. Just use the same idea. That's all I do.
The rule is not always general. For example, you can't do the Sarigamaga and Bilahari, for example. I'm just saying.
Bilahari is an organic raga. It's not a scale.
Yeah. Yeah.
No.
Correct. Just like you can do the Padanida and Kamboji.
No, the Sangati called Rigamaga, Risa and Bilahari, by the way.
Yeah, but it's not...
It is not a wrong Sangati at all. It's perfectly correct.
But we don't sing it as a phrase, as a signature phrase
of
Bilahari.
I didn't say I'm going to sing Padanida as a signature phrase in Jayantasena. I said it's an opportunity you have. Now, Rigamaga is definitely usable in Bilahari. Now, we've decided to cleanse it because we have a problem with Rigamaga. It's our problem, not Bilahari's problem. Classic Rigamaga Pamagarisa is a classic Bilahari phrase. All the greats have sung it. Today, we don't sing it much because we are antsy about it. If you know Rigamaga, Sarigapa, unnecessary. In my opinion. I sang the same phrase. You can use it. You can use it. It's up to you. You don't have to keep it as the primary phrase of Bilahari. It is, and by the way, even in this form, it is not a primary phrase in Bilahari. It's one of those tertiary phrases. But if you can still use that idea in a scalular raga. That's my point. The fact that you can use this concept in a raga that's come up from a scale, then the raga escapes the scale. This is what I would do. This is what I do. What I do is I use exactly organic raga's ideas. What all we have done, take a bagada. Gari gama da ma re sa, gama pa da pa da ni da pa, gama da ma gari ga sa gari gama pa da pa. There's a phrase that Papa Venkatramaya used to play. Sa ga pa ma la la. Outstanding phrase. Nobody sings it today. Because you have a problem with sa ga pa. Just listen to that phrase. Why are we losing these phrases? I would say... If you take Begada, the re in many of these ragas where you have this turn coming, you know, it's very interesting. So this turn is, the turn swaram is a weak swaram, always. Sagari gari is weak. This raga. Sagama badapa can be sung in Begada. Because ri is weak. So if I have another scale which has sagariga, then I use this. Anandabhari is an old raga. Anandabhari also has sagariga, sagama is allowed. So take a scale now.
Bindu Malini.
Bindu Malini. Bindu Malini. Bindu Malini. Bindu Malini. Bindu Malini. Scale padu. Padu. எனக்கு தெரியாது, சத்தியமா தெரியாது.
கரி கம ப நி ச ச நி ச ல ப க
க ர ட ர ர ந ர ந த த ர ந டிஃபரண்டா பண்ணலாம். த த ர ந வை நாட் யூஸ் இட். ஸோ வாட் யூ நீட் டு டூ இஸ் திஸ் இஸ் வை வென் வி டீச் கர்நாடிக் மியூசிக் வி சே வி நீட் டு ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லேர்ன் தி ஓல்ட் ராகாஸ். யூ நீட் நோ த ஆனந்த பைரவிஸ், சுரட்டிஸ், அட்டானாஸ், பேகடாஸ், பிலஹரிஸ், ஆல் தீஸ் யூ நீட் நோ இன்சைட் அவுட். Because they don't depend on any swaram. They depend on what you hear and the phrase. The moment, it's like when we were young, we used to always have this conversation. When we were all coming up in the late 80s and 90s, we were a huge gang of us chatting with each other. We used to have major arguments about most things on street corners. We used to go hitting each other on street corners on whether Dharmavati is a raga or not. It was ridiculous. We used to have these huge fights. And so that most important thing was that, and that was most of us, and we were lucky to have gurus who also stressed on learning these older ragas. After which, then you learn how to use those ideas into these scales. Then there's a possibility, you're not going to move them too much. Let's also accept a reality that the scale has its, because it's come from a non-organic process of evolution, this is my opinion, it cannot be expanded beyond a point. Because it'll ultimately come back trapped to its very rigid structure. But yet, there's some breathing space. And this usually happens in a scale which is convoluted. A scale which is linear is a hopeless situation. You'll have to just run up and down 15 times, as many times as possible. You may do it very well, it'll sound very good. That's a different thing. But it cannot run away from it. Because if you sing Latangi, you have to show Da always, you have to keep showing Ga always. If you show Da too much and don't show Ga, it sounds like something else. If you show Ga too much, it sounds like Kalyani, then you're stuck with. So that's why the ragas you hear in linear scales will be up and down. Charukeshi, same problem. Kiravani, to a large extent, same problem. Illangriya, Murikira. Kiravani, he was little, he objected to it. He has a feeling, Kiravani is not so bad. Okay, fine. Kiravani, we let Kiravani go. Fine. But you understand. So so that is what we do. So that's why I said Padanida is allowed. Because I watched Kamboji. Even in Begada, we do it. So those ideas we have to use. These are the things you teach in class. These are the things you teach in class so that then they can use these ideas and move ahead. Now, there was a composition. There was a composer called Spencer Venugopal. So, he actually had asked him for a composition. And he tuned it. He didn't Bahudari. He said, there is no slow composition. And he's a fabulous composer. I mean, I really like his music a lot. He's a great lover of the Dhanama Bani. Brindama's music. So I wanted a composition on love. On love, not in romantic love, but love. Anbu, as we say in Tamil. Anbe jeevadaram. In that. Tunbayirul maraya tuya oli niraya. Is a skill. He brought a phrase. He introduces this phrase. It's a brilliant phrase. Now this kind of gives a Bahudari a breather. Okay, this also possible. And in fact, when he sent it to me, he thought I won't sing the phrase. So when he heard, he said, oh, you sang the phrase. I said, it's a fabulous phrase. Now this is also another case, which is also where is he learned from? He's learned from old ragas. It's not something that he has created in that sense, but he's figured that old ragas, we allow these things. Right? We always, another thing we do, no? In the ragas, wherever in the older ragas, you have Sani Dani Pa, Sani Pa will be allowed. These little things, the weak note, whenever there's a weak note, you can skip the weak note and move ahead. So these are things you can always incorporate, and they will give you then a new perspective to these ragams. So we'll just sing. I will take the same kirtanam. Kirtanam padla. Fulla padla. Vinata sutava shri ramana vinata sutava shri ramana vinata sutava shri ramana vinata sutava shri ramana manasa rakase vinchada rama vinata sutava shri ramana manasa rakase vinchada rama vinata sutava shri ramana manasa rakase vinchada rama vinata. This indication is tadara tadara no, it's coming from there. Nino saraguju, nino saraguju, dani mradu kela. Nino saraguju, dani mradu kela. Nino saraguju, dani mradu kela. Nino saraguju. Dani mradu ke la manu chunane la jivana me la manu chunane la jivana me la vinata sutava khana shri ramana manasara kase vinchada rama vinata sutava sutava hana shri
mata bheda mane sagarna chakasam
matava bulu balkota sukham mata bheda mane sagarna chakasam matava bulu balkota sukham mata bheda mane
Mani da ni ba da ma da ba da ma pa ni da ba da ma ni da ma ta bhe ni da ba ma pa ta ni da ba ma ga ma ni da da ba ma pa ma pa ni da ma ta bhe ma pa ni da ba da ni da ba da sa ma ga sa ni da ba ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe ma ga pa ma ga ga sa pa ma ga sa ga da ma ga sa ga da sa ma ga ma ta bhe da sa ga sa ni da ba da ni da ba ma ba ni da ba da sa sa ni ni da da ba ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe ma pa ni da ba da ni da ba da sa ma ga sa sa ni da ba ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe ma pa ni da ba da ni da ba da sa ma ga sa sa ni da ba ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe 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 ma ga sa ga ma ta b
dasa gaza ni dasa pada samata beda
pada samada gama gaza dasa sani dapa sani ni damata
sa sa ni dasa gama gama gaza ni dasa ni dapa dasa gamata
beda sa gama gaza sani dasa sani dapa ni dapa sani damata be
sani dapada gaza ni dapada maga sani dapada sani dapa mata beda sani da pa da sa ga sa ga ma ga sa ni da pa ma pa ma ta
ma pa ma ga ma pa ni da pa ma pa sa ni da pa ga sa sa ni da pa da ma ta bhe
pa da ni da pa da pa ma da da pa ma ga sa ma ta bhe sa ga ma sa ga ma pa sa da pa ta sa sa ni da pa pa ma ga sa ni da pa ma ta
bhe sa ni da pa da pa ma sa pa ma pa ma ga sa ni da ma ta bhe
ni da pa ni da pa da sa da sa da ga sa sa ni pa ni da pa ma ta bhe ma ni da pa ma pa sa da da pa ma ga sa pa pa ma ga sa ni da sa ga ma
sabash
ni da sa ma ga sa ma ga sa pa pa ma ni da pa pa ma ta bhe
pa da pa sa da ga sa ma ga sa ga da sa sa ni da pa ma ga sa ni da sa ga ma ta bhe ma ga sa ni da sa ga da ga ga sa ni da sa pa sa ni da ni ma ni da pa pa ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe
so
ma ma ga ma sa ni da ni da pa ni da da pa pa ma ga sa ga ma ta bhe
so yeah so this exchange also becomes very important so you then start titrating what are the possibilities what you can sing what you cannot sing and of course this is smaller ragam so there's only so much you can do but then the bigger ragams then there's so much more you can do again like I said you don't have to finish at ma ga sa ga ma pa you can finish wherever you want question is how do you know to aesthetically bring it back to where the actual line is